Okay guys, we will start the trading. So just need to confirm if everybody is able to see the screen. Perfect. So today's training is all about creating an e-commerce website using WordPress and WooCommerce. So there will be a couple of parts to it. So the first part is how to get a domain.
Sorry to interrupt, Arnab. Is it okay if you record the session?
Yep, I'm already recording, I think. Yes.
Okay.
All right. Okay. So yes, there are two prerequisites to this training. One is that you will have to buy a domain, and the second is you will need to get a hosting on cPanel. Now these two are pretty simple. You can simply go to Google and you can just type in cPanel hosting, and you'll get a ton of options to buy from. So you can get it from GoDaddy, you can get it from HostGator, you can get it from Hostinger.inc. So there are multiple of service providers who provide the cPanel hosting. So all you have to do is sign up with them, and there will be multiple charges or whatever the charges are for cPanel. They will take that. So some cPanel hosting service providers take a monthly basic charge, and some take it as a one-time charge, or some also take it as a yearly charges. So you can check whichever best suits you. You can go for that plan, and accordingly you can start your cPanel. Now setting up cPanel is very easy. You don't have to do anything. Once you purchase any plan from any service provider, right, they will ask you for your domain. If you have a domain, you can insert the domain, or if you don't have a domain, they will help you find a domain. So post you find a domain, they will create a cPanel account for you, and they will give you the login details. So once you are logged into cPanel, you can straight away start hosting websites. You don't have to set up anything, because with the bundle of cPanel, they will also give you a cPanel which is already ready to be hosted. So right, there are a couple of things. Now if you see the cPanel will look something of this sort. So this will be a login screen. Your username and password will be given by the hosting service provider that you choose. And if you enter the username and password of cPanel, you will be presented with this sort of a screen. So this is the cPanel interface. Now, before everything, what actually cPanel is? cPanel was started 20 years ago, and it was just a very small company. So they started very low profile, and gradually their services were recognized by all major hosting service providers, and they were quickly adopted throughout the globe. So if you see their website, So they are in this market for a very long time. So basically they provide you a hosting automation platform wherein if you are hosting a website using your normal servers, you will have to create all sorts of name servers, all sort of DNS entries. So cPanel simplifies that for you, and it's sort of a consortium, just like your internet banking, where you find all of your hosting needs at one place. Now, various cPanel have various sort of features enabled into it. So if you see this cPanel, which I have purchased from GoDaddy, so if you find here, you will see that they are offering me 15 email accounts. So any email account, for example, info@yourdomain.com, then for example, right now we are using the domain digitalpalette.tech. So digitalpalette.tech, various email accounts under digitalpalette.tech, like info@digitalpalette.tech, customerservice@digitalpalette.tech. So any sort of email address, up to 15 email address, I can set it up on this cPanel. All right, then this is the disk usage capacity. So I have taken for demonstration and my normal usage, I have taken 1 GB. Now this depends upon the package you take. So some hosting provider provides you 1 TB, some provides you 500 GB, some may provide you unlimited disk usage. So this is how the package. So it just similar to the network package you take, 410 rupees Jio plan is different, 200 rupees Jio plan is different. Similarly, various packages will have various features which they will give you while you join in. So if you see in this, so here you will get it. So for example, this is for one website, this is for unlimited websites. So as I was talking, unmetered bandwidth, this is also unmetered bandwidth. Now this is the web storage that I was talking about. This is 100 GB storage. Here it's unlimited storage. So similarly, for various packages, you get various features. Obviously, the higher the packages, the more features you get. Right, then for me, the bandwidth stands at 15.212 GB, which means my website, whichever it is hosted on this cPanel, any of my website will have a capacity to reach 12.12 GB. Post that, this particular server will crash. So whatever functions you want to do with your domain, with respect to if you want to have a IP blocker, IP blocked from visiting your website, you can do that. If you want to, as explained, if you want to set up email accounts, you can do that from this tab. If you want to publish a site, if you want to use the domain, add-on domains, have a subdomain. Now, what is subdomain? So subdomain will be something like arnab.digitalpalette.tech. So anything of this sort is known as subdomain. So you are dividing a domain into multiple domains under the same mother domain, which is digitalpalette.tech. So this is how the cPanel features are described here. So for example, if you see, I have hosted a couple of websites in this domain. So how does that work? I'll just show you. So these are all directories that is there in my domain. Okay, so now if I want to see a particular website which I have created, so if you just click on any of these folder, you will find the website stored in that folder. So this is how a domain name looks like, and this is how a particular folder looks like. Now this is a website which is hosted right in this particular cPanel, and it is being viewed from this cPanel only. I'll show you how to do it, and I'll also show you how to have direct, whenever you type this domain name, whenever you punch in this, just the digitalpalette.tech, a website should pop up. This would be the first training for today as to how this can be the domain can work, or the domain can host your website. So to host any website, you will have simply have to go to File Manager, and under file manager you will find public HTML. So whatever you put in the public HTML, that particular listing will be displayed, or that HTML files, whatever is there in that particular directory, it will get displayed whenever anyone punches your domain name. Right, so this is how you open the directory. So whatever you are viewing here, it is the public HTML directory. So your public HTML directory carries all the main files for displaying. So I have public.html, so I click on it, and if you remember, if I just punch the domain name again, you will see this list being displayed here. Why? Because this does not find any website to be displayed, because I have not entered any website here. All these are particular folders within which I have created individual websites. So if I create one more folder here and I write it as old, and I select all of these websites except the old one, and then I move all of these inside my old folder. So this has gone in the old folder, and now in my public HTML there is nothing except old. So consider that I want to put in any website of my own. Let's say I want to put this coming soon. So I'll first download this. So this cPanel uploader file upload section can recognize any individual files, and if you want to club all the files and send, then you will have to use .zip format. So .zip format is an extension which is recognized by the cPanel's file manager, which you can use to upload multiple files all together and then extract here in this platform. So as I said, I go to the public HTML folder, I click on upload, and in upload I select the file that I want to, I drag and drop here. Now once this is uploaded, this will turn green, which means it should be uploaded. Let me see, it come here, right. So see, it has turned green, which means it has finished uploading. All you need to do is extract this zip file in the public HTML directory. So I just click on extract and I leave it to public HTML, and when I click on extract file, so this website is now currently on my public HTML place. So now since it has a index.html, it has a CSS file and all the files, or all the files which are required to display a website, whenever somebody clicks digitalpalette.tech, now it will show the website that I have hosted there. So now you see, the first time when I navigated to digitalpalette.tech, it was showing me a list, because over there it didn't have any such files. But now I have hosted a website with index.html or index.php, and now it will display the website accurately over here. So this is how simple is cPanel for any website hosting. So this is the first part that I wanted to explain, because just not any e-commerce, but any website that you want to show, anything or any website if you want to show, you can show it using cPanel. So similarly, now you know that this old folder has all my previous listings, right? So what I would do, I would go to the subfolder old, and it is just like a C directory operation in your command prompt. So if you want to visit any directory, you change the directory. So similarly, you can change the directory using the slash command, and whenever you go into further directories inside of any directory, it will start displaying any file that is available there. This is same as your C, your command prompt. This is same as your run command. So it is all a directory listing. So now again, if you click any particular folder, it will display that particular website. So this is another website that has been hosted. So you can see as soon as I click there, it starts to open that particular website as well. So it is very simple to host your own website on a cPanel. All you need is one domain name and a particular cPanel account purchased from any good vendor. So do not purchase from anywhere that you get. Just purchase from somewhere which has a reputed name in hosting. So we all see GoDaddy nowadays is displaying ads, and then you have BigRock, you also have HostGator, you also have various service provider who gives you or who sells the cPanel website. So now we will move to the next part. Before moving, just a quick question roundup. If you have any question till now, please raise them and I would answer them, or you can type them in the chat section as well. Okay, so now we will proceed further. So we can use multiple tools to create the e-commerce that we want to create. First, you need to understand the type of e-commerce website that you would want to create, because not every e-commerce requires a particular type of tool. I'll explain you what I'm talking about in a couple of minutes. Just to confirm once again, all are able to see my screen. Am I right? Please, can you please confirm?
Yes. Yes, I can.
Okay, thank you. Right, so when we are creating an e-commerce website, we don't need, now, you know, if you want to create an e-commerce website, first you can go the hard way, which is you can code it individually in your laptop, desktop, check it by hosting in your local host, then seeing and correcting. You can go that way, or you can go the easiest way, which is you can simply use a feature in cPanel, which is known as Softaculous Apps Installer. It is a software which is provided by cPanel. Now, when you are purchasing the cPanel software, just ensure from the service provider if it has Softaculous Installer inbuilt in it. Why? Because if somebody is selling you cPanel at 100 rupees a month, they cannot afford this Softaculous, because Softaculous is again a paid software to cPanel. So the reseller purchases the cPanel, and from where he is purchasing, that particular reseller has to integrate the cPanel and Softaculous app installer and then resell it to GoDaddy or whichever service provider you are asking for. So it is always advisable that whenever you want to purchase a cPanel, kindly inquire if the Softaculous app is installer is available. And in some of the description where you would purchase, in detailed description, this would be mentioned, Softaculous available. But as far as I know, more than 98% of the market service providers do provide Softaculous inbuilt. But just to be on a safe side, do inquire. So now, using Softaculous apps installer, we can install or make an e-commerce website without having a zero knowledge about coding. Alright. So as soon as you click on Softaculous, this screen comes up. Now in this, not only e-commerce, you can make enormous number of websites within clicks. So if you see towards the left hand side, you would find many of the topics listed there. So you can create a blog, you can create a CMS software, you can create e-commerce, you can create image galleries, you can also create Wikipedia. So the Wikipedia which you see today, you can create an exact looking website using this Softaculous. How? So if you just click on Media Wiki, if you click on install now, all you need to do is give a name. This is just like you install a software, you would find a resemblance in the steps that I'm doing now. Okay, so under now HTTPS, this is the secured or the hypertext that you want to use. So since this cPanel which I have purchased has HTTPS inbuilt, now again HTTPS inbuilt cPanel costs a bit more as compared to normal HTTP. Just that this website or this cPanel has the SSL inbuilt in it. So now if you are already into website hosting, since I am into website hosting for I think now 10 years straight. So initially when I was in the college, when I used to do all these work, I used to have to pay separately for SSL to be installed on my domain, and that too only an expert could do it. So that was, you know, a very roundup process. You know, I have to first purchase a domain, then again purchase SSL, give the SSL certificate details to the domain service provider, the domain person installs the SSL in the domain, and then he links this to the cPanel. So all of these now have just come into one place, which is if you just tick a box when you are purchasing cPanel before making a payment, add SSL. If you just click on it, the SSL would be automatically inbuilt on your cPanel, and when you install any of these softwares, you will be able to find the HTTPS automatically selected, which means you are already installing the software that you are about to on a secured server, which means all the payments, payment gateway, trust certificate, everything is valid in the same installation that you are about to do now. All right then. Okay, so this is my domain, as you have seen, digitalpalette.tech. Now if you have any subdomains, as I explained earlier, arnab.digitalpalette.tech, if you have some subdomains, you can select those domains from this drop down. Now only digitalpalette.tech, because I don't have any subdomains. Now if you just have digitalpalette.tech, and this is your in directory, now leave it blank. If you just want to, you know, if you just want to type digitalpalette.tech, and if you want to view the Wikipedia website without entering any slash folder name, leave this blank. But since I'm using this for demo purpose, I will write Wikipedia, do anything. So if you just type wiki, you can leave all these, you can put a email address where the email will go. Just look at the username and password. I'll just change it. I'll just keep it same. And click on enable upload. So these are all options. And now email installation details too. This is very important, because if you don't enter any of your details here, you would not receive any installation details for this particular software. What I mean by installation details, so if you look here, you would receive email from the server saying you that you have installed. All right, guys, can you please mute because it creates disturbance. Sajad, mute kar le bhai. Right. So it will send you an email with all the details of the installation that you have done. So you can, in case you forget any username or password, you can come back and you can search the mail to get it. Now once you have filled in all these details, click install, and it will install the just give me a minute. Right, it will install the particular software for you. Okay. Right. Now you would see that it says the wiki has already installed. So now if you go to this link, you will find an exact version of Wikipedia installed. So whenever you first install this, it would take some time because all the directories and the folders would align itself accordingly. But yes, it would come up and it would be an exact copy of Wikipedia. So this is how Wikipedia looks. So now you have your own Wikipedia. You can use this to display multiple records, multiple texts. You can make your own Wikipedia. You can create your own Wikipedia. You can do anything which probably Wikipedia does. You can change this icon. You can change the way the top feature looks. So basically, this is how Wikipedia is created. So they already have this wiki software installed on their servers, and from there they manage all these things. So this is how first you install install the software. So there are various, as I said, there are various multiple instances or multiple things that you can do using the Softiculous. Not only e-commerce, you can create your own social networking website. You can create your own invoicing website. So this is the website that I use for invoicing various clients. So I simply go here and I create invoices. I just forgot that I moved it. Alright, so now we will move forward to installing the e-commerce software in it. So I'm removing this. So if you see about social networking, you have these many social networks available. So all of them are social networking platforms where you can have your own social media installed. Then you have ad management, just like Google management. You can create your own ad managers. You can have your own webmails. You can create your own polls. You have project management, which also has office in it, which has web collaborations in it. You can also create an ERP website using it. You can create customer support, where you can create and manage tickets. So if you are a service provider, if you buy anything from GoDaddy, whenever you have an issue, you raise a ticket. So when you raise a ticket, they open the ticket and work on it. So that is called ticket management. So you can create your own ticket management or customer support. You can create your own music website. You can create your own video website. So there are endless opportunities what you can do using the Softiculous. But today our main focus is on e-commerce. So if you click on e-commerce, these many platforms are available. Now to have any of these working, you will have to have a basic knowledge of how to create an e-commerce website at least. So once you go through today's tutorial, you will be able to gain knowledge on how to create the e-commerce, from where to upload the products, from where to change the country, tax, currency. You can make invoices, send invoices, manage your order, understand how actually Flipkart works as a whole or Amazon works as a whole. So there are various versions of e-commerce software. So you might have heard what is Magento. Magento is the software on which Amazon, entire Amazon was created. So you can also have Magento from here. Obviously, Magento needs much more bandwidth. So my cPanel is 1 GB. Magento itself needs at least 1.5 GB to install. So you cannot install Magento in a very low bandwidth cPanel, right? For that, the bandwidth has to be very high. So if you see in today's world, it's not just the e-commerce website that you create. You also need to have multiple thread support to it. So everything is not possible in a mobile, right? So if you are manufacturing a mobile, you will have to have the camera module, you will have to have the SIM module, you will need to have the screen module, you will need to have speaker module. So these, you can create an aluminium case on which you will be placing those particular bits and pieces. That is what it does. It gives you a platform to create. But you need to have various modules which you can connect to that platform in order to make a complete website. So payment module cannot be given to you by just a PrestaShop or AvanteCart. So by itself, they don't have a payment module. You may need to contact Paytm, or you may need to contact RazorPay. You may need to contact MobiQuick to give you a module which you can take and install in the e-commerce website that you are building. So in today's world, or in today's market, the only softwares which are currently having a very high advantage or high demand, those are PrestaShop, those are WooCommerce, those are OpenCart, Magento. So these are the particular software platforms which will have multiple support from all the payment gateways, logistics. So Delhivery, if you know that partner, they have integrations which can which supports PrestaShop software, Magento software, and WooCommerce. So rest of these e-commerce software, they don't support. So you need to always pick the ones on which you are creating a website based on the support that is available from your market. So in India, you can create a e-commerce on PrestaShop. You can create an e-commerce on PrestaShop or Magento or WordPress plus WooCommerce. So this is a site which I have created using PrestaShop. So this website is created completely using PrestaShop. So this is a very very much working e-commerce website. I'll have to first reset what I have done. Just give me a minute. So if you look at any of the job sites, and if you just type e-commerce and search, you will find Magento developer required, PrestaShop developer required. So Magento is like the mother of all softwares, or all your e-commerce softwares. So I'll just delete all of these and I'll get back all the files. Back to my public HTML folder. Right. So I hope this should not give an error. Yep, it doesn't give an error now. Yeah, so now you see that this is how an e-commerce site will look if you make it from PrestaShop. So if you click on any product, you can simply go to the product. And every piece, bit of information that you see here, it is available to write on the PrestaShop platform. So this is an e-commerce software given by PrestaShop. So this has everything, right? From now, what I was talking about module. So you see these tweet, share, Google, Pinterest. This is a social media module. Now I'll have to there are several modules available which I have to click and install within PrestaShop, so that those are seen on this particular product page. So that is how a module works. So you see this this add to cart, and from add to cart you pay via Google Pay, or you pay via debit card, credit card. So all of those are various modules which are available from particular service providers. So you select everything that is there. So everything what you are seeing here, this is all created within that software. So there is nothing which is like you will have to code, or you will have to buy something. There is nothing to purchase, there is nothing to code. Every bit of information or everything that you are seeing there is automatically available with the software that you are installing. So this is the journey that I'll show you, and then I'll show you how to make something in the similar lines using WordPress. So once you click to proceed to checkout. So now you see this Paytm, pay with Paytm, this module has been taken from Paytm. If you visit developers.paytm, so when you go to Paytm, you would find these particular models which are already available there, and you can download the module. You can download the modules and you can integrate with your PrestaShop to create this payment gateway available. So as soon as I click on Pay with Paytm, it will take me to a Paytm payment page where I'll need to enter my card details and everything, and I'll be able to purchase these products, which is how the Paytm works, or the e-commerce works. So now you see that I have everything there. I am now on a Paytm payment gateway page, wherein I can simply enter the details over here and my order will be confirmed. So this is the e-commerce journey, right from beginning to end, what we will be learning. So the first part is to install WordPress. So as explained, as pretty much simple, we will is everyone able to hear and see my screen now?
No, I cannot. I mean, I can hear you, but I can't see you. I mean, yes, see your screen.
Okay. Just working on it. Okay, so is it visible now?
Yes, sir, we can see. Everything is okay, sir.
Those who are
okay, and then we can go ahead because I can't see it. It's fine, I'll listen to it.
Okay. All right. If you're able to hear, I can. I'll share the screen recording later as well. But
okay.
I think many of them are able to see. Only some are not able to, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, moving forward, now once you are on yep, I will share the video. Yes, I will. Okay, now once we are on WordPress, all you have to do is click on install now. And once again, as I said, you can enter your own directory. You can enter your own directory. So for this demo, I'll just write demo one. Site name, let's put as TechShopee. Okay, site description, I'll leave it blank. Sorry, you can't leave it blank. Just enter two dots. Username and password, you can just type in. And then you can select any one of these themes which are available here, or you can just ignore. I'll just ignore. So just click on install. So see, earlier when I installed the Wikipedia software, I selected send the installation details. So this is how the installation details will come. So in case you forgot the admin URL or what username was there or what database did you use, you can use it. So suppose you have created multiple websites and you want to cleanse the database because that is where all your data is stored. So you can see the database which you need and you can delete the rest of them. It's that easy. Now see, it has now been installed. The software of WordPress has been installed now. So you can see the WordPress software here. And this is my admin panel. So this is how your WordPress blank WordPress will look like. So any post that you put here, anything that you add, you will be able to it will be visible on this page whenever someone lands up to this domain. And this is your dashboard, which is the admin panel. So since I have logged in using the same username password, it is not required to re-enter those. It is just simply you can, it will just land you on the admin dashboard directly. So first step should be update whatever it is asking you to update. Just update those. Just click on update and click on update plugins. Okay, now you see the dashboard looks something of this sort. So it is here that you will be able to see all your order details and whatever your order statuses are, how many products are out of stock, how many are in stock, everything would be shown in this particular dashboard. So this is the image, or this is the first place where you will find an insight to your e-commerce website. Okay, so you can create posts, as you can see various news agencies and all, they type in. How do they type in? They type basically here. So any post that you want, you can create here. You can edit this particular post that is already there. Okay, now is the screen available to all? I think it should be. Yep. Vikalp, glad you could join. Sajjad, Jyoti Prakash, Arpit, all those who wrote to me that the screen aren't visible. Okay. No problem. Yes, it is the bandwidth issue. That's the reason why it is taking such a long time. Okay, so if you see, this is the hello world. I mean, this is the post that we are editing. So I'll write here, today we are learning e-commerce creation, and I write hello world. I click update. See, it now shows post updated at the bottom. Now as soon as you refresh this, so this is editing your content. It is so easy using WordPress. Now whatever you type, this will show on your website. So here you can add image, you can add slideshow, you can add a video, you can add anything that you wish. You can do it from here. This is your website, this is your blog. You can do a lot using it. Okay, so see, this is so basically this is how this website was created. So this particular website was created using the same principle. It has all the blogs. It has the blog section where an image or a slideshow or a video is displayed. So as you go ahead, you can look for multiple trainings and tutorials in YouTube and try to, you know, be more innovative on creating your blog. So that is all about the blog, because if you are all only creating e-commerce, you don't have to bother about these screens will go away, because the software that we are going to put in the WordPress would be different. So how we do that? So I hope you all are clear about what is WordPress, and now we go about creating the e-commerce store. So first we required WordPress, and then we will now require WooCommerce. So I'll type here, it is WooCommerce. Okay, just note the spelling, right? We don't have to search for it. It is due to the bandwidth that the websites are loading slow, but if you see that this is my blog website wherein I have created multiple blogs, various topics and all, and you can create similar blogs using WordPress. Okay, so in the dashboard or in the admin panel, you first have to go to plugins and then add new plugin. Once this page opens, search for plugin WooCommerce, hit enter, and you would see the first plugin, which is WooCommerce. So just click on install now and let it do its job. Right, now I said about modules, right? So this is one module, which is WooCommerce. It is for your e-commerce business. Now this is another module for creating invoices and packing slips. Invoices is something that you get on your email address once you purchase something from Amazon, and packing slips are something which is pasted on the top of the parcel that you receive. So that is how you can create WooCommerce PDF invoices and packing slips. Now payment gateway, there is a different for Stripe payment gateway. You have this particular plugin. Then MailChimp, this is used to do promotional emails to your customers. You have PayPal, which is another plugin. Now WooCommerce admin is something which is just like your WordPress dashboard, so you don't need that. So this is again, you can using this white Git WooCommerce wishlist, you can create a wishlist kind of a thing for customers, just like your Amazon or Flipkart. So multiple various plugins for different functionality. You will have some of these plugins pre-built, means as soon as now you install the WooCommerce, WooCommerce will itself automatically install few of these plugins which it requires to have a smooth store run up. Alright, so now I have installed it and I'll click on activate. Once you click on activate, it will install all various plugins which it requires to work, and it will give you a list of all the plugins once everything is completed to completed installing. So this is how the WooCommerce installation starts. So it will take you to their installation window. So you just go on with the flow and it will give you various options to do. So now it would ask you where is your store based. I will write here. Country would be India. And it should be. Right, India, West Bengal. City again, type Kolkata, postcode, and click on continue. Okay, in which industry does the store operate? So as I said, various demands, and you can use various categories. So as of now, let's say I'll use electronics and computers. Let's click continue. Okay, so what type of products would be listed? So mine, I would be delivering physical products. So if you are now giving any services, you can click on subscriptions. If you are using memberships, you can use membership, composite products, bookings. So mostly we would have either physical products, or if you are doing any online virtual product business, like example PDF, question papers, or anything which does not need a physical delivery, you can select physical products. Or if you have just downloads, track, video, what you say, those pictures, if you are selling your pictures, photography, then you can just click on downloads. And if it's just physical products, leave it to physical products, click continue. Now, how many products do you plan to display? Let's say 1 to 10. Currently selling elsewhere. No, I don't sell anywhere. So this is all optional. So if you want to create a market on Facebook, you can choose it. As I said, as I was showing you all the plugins, I said customers on MailChimp, you can send them mails if you want to, otherwise just disable it. Now if you have a Google Ads account, you can link it, or you can just disable it. So I have Facebook, I can click on it and then I can link my Facebook page to this. It will just ask me anything after facebook.com/ whatever it is you input there, it will start displaying your Facebook page on the store. So this is a very much advanced version of any e-commerce software that is there out in the market. So we don't require this market on Facebook as of now. I'll just click continue. For those who wanting to have a Facebook store installed, just select there and just go. Right, now you have theme, you can select the theme that you want. You want paid themes. If you are building it up for a client, it is always better to use paid themes because you get a license to make it commercial. If you are making it for your own, for just selling, for just displaying and selling small products, not that big. If you're not using it for a commercial purpose, that is, if you're not using it for a client, just go with free themes. select any one of the theme that you want, whichever you look, it looks nice for you. So as per me, I'll go with this one. I'll just click on choose, and that is it. Storefront was installed on your website. Storefront, it was activated on your site. Now WordPress has done everything that I wanted to do. Now this is enhance your store with WooCommerce services. This is where, as I said, that WooCommerce will start installing all the packages which are related to WooCommerce from the plugin store. If you just click on yes, it says it will be activated for free, and that is it. Because as I said earlier, you will not have to pay a single penny once you have purchased a domain and your cPanel. Everything post that would be free thanks to Softaculous and then WordPress and then WooCommerce. That being done, let's wait. It will install everything, and once done, it will give you a green signal that you can now start to install your products. Okay, now this is a Jetpack. Jetpack is a service with WooCommerce which helps to organize your store. It is a paid up service, it is not a free service. So those who wish to buy can buy, and if you don't want to buy, just click on, you can just ignore this. Let's see how does our store look now. So now you see the basic look of your website has changed. You will find your home, cart, checkout, my account, sample page and shop. You click on shop, you will have all your products listed. And you would not have to bother about all the side rows. I'll show you how to disable this and have a complete website with all of these sliders and everything which looks good on a website. Okay, now everything has been done, so just go to your admin link. Once you are in your admin link, we will upload the product and show how does it look like. Okay, so first things first, how I want my website to look, that I'll have to first decide. Okay, so we'll go section wise. So first, I don't need this entire portion. I want my website to look a full page website with proper sliders present and some products below the slider, so that whenever the customer comes in, they can simply click on that product and they can purchase it. So for that, first I'll have to add some product. Now when you are in your dashboard, you would find these many new changes available. So if you see on WooCommerce, since we have already received a welcoming screen by WooCommerce where I have set up the location as India and I'll be selling 10 products, etc., etc., you don't have to set up your currency or shipping method, because WooCommerce will automatically do it for you. So first, now we would straight away jump, we'll create some products. So for products explanatory, you can just go on products, and first we would check if there are any default products which are added. Right. So there are no products currently which are added. So we would create our product. So we'll just have one or two products created for this session, and we would use all our functionalities to work along with that. So before setting up e-commerce website, you will first have to tie up with any one of the payment gateway providers. You can do that with PayPal, you can do that with Paytm. Okay, having an account in Paytm, which you do right now for accepting and receiving payments, paying on shop, that will not work. For e-commerce business, you need to set up a business account with Paytm. You can simply Google it and you will get it. Now, either you can use Paytm, you can use PayPal, or you can use PayU, Razorpay. Whatever it is, you must have one payment gateway ready, up and running. For this tutorial, I'll show you how to use PayPal to integrate. So, product name, we'll just see. Okay, so we will list sell off mouse. So I have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 5 images. So we will have, let's say, mouse. So let mouse be our product. Go to add media. We'll add the image. Right, so all of the images are added. I'll click insert into product. So now my images are ready. See, these many images are available. Okay, so this is a description section. You can either insert image here, you can insert text here, you can insert videos here, you can insert multiple things out here. It's not a problem. So I'll write mouse imported, and I can write quality assured, brands HP, Dell. Right, let this be the description. Okay, now I need to create a category. Okay, so if I'm selling computer peripherals, then I'll have mouse, I'll have keyboard, I'll have monitors, laptops, n number of things. And if I'm creating a apparel e-commerce, then I'll have t-shirts, trousers, shoes. If I'm creating a bakery, then I'll have cake, chocolates. So the common entities like cakes, chocolates, which can be further classified, we will have to create a category for that. So since I'm creating a peripheral e-commerce, for mouse, keyboard, I won't have to use any category. But however, since I'm showing it and you would be applying it, let's create a category. So you can just go from here to categories and add, or you can just click add new category over here, and it will give you an option. Just type in here as peripherals. Parent category is something in that if you want to put a category in another category. So for example, I create a category for a bakery shop. Let's say edible in 2 hours, edible in 4 hours. Now edible in 2 hours will have chocolates, biscuits, cakes. Edible in 4 hours will have cakes, breads, namkeens. Under chocolate, again I'll have lollipop, bars, toffee, candy. Again under cakes, I'll have chocolate, vanilla. So from top to bottom, mother child, all the mothers would form categories, all the childs would form products. So you will have to first jot out on a piece of paper the categories that you want to in want to be available, and accordingly you can create the category. So you can create n number of categories, that's not a problem. So as of now I am creating peripherals. I'll just click add new category. Okay, wait. Right, now you see the category peripherals is now added. Okay. Now this is the product name, this is the link of the product, or this is the description of the product, and here the details of the product would start. So product data, it's a simple product. If it is a virtual, which means any photo or any video that you are selling, and if it is downloadable, that is if somebody is buying your photograph and instead of sending it later you want him to download it then and there, post a payment, you can click on downloadable. Okay, so in general I click regular. Under regular I say suppose one mouse is about 150 rupees, let's say 200 rupees, and on sale I sell it of 150 rupees. I can schedule the sale as to when the sale price should end. Just say we have in Flipkart sale ends tonight, sale ends on after 4 days, sale ends in 2 days. So that is all you can do with schedule. And the next thing would be your inventory. Inventory is how many products do you have, and SKU is how many, sorry, SKU is a particular stock keeping unit which is identifiable. So whenever you go to any website, any e-commerce website, you would be able to find a number which is always associated with the product. So you can check on Flipkart, just below the name or somewhere alongside the name you would find a number, alphanumeric code, which is available. So that is store keeping unit or stock keeping unit, which is used to identify that product. So if this entire thing has to be automated using robots, so your name will not go, the product name will not go, the SKU will get, you will go. So I'll just randomly name this. So let's say digital palette product peripherals, and then mouse product one. So this is my unique code. So this SKU cannot change no matter how similar the product is, it cannot change. Okay, next is if you want to give the stock available to be displayed on the website, say suppose you have 5 pieces of it left, 10 pieces of it left, you click on manage stock and it will ask you how many products are available. If you don't want to manage the stock, just uncheck this, and you can also set the stock status. You can either have it in stock, out stock, just say you can see on Flipkart item not available, item out of stock, available next. In Swiggy there is an option right now which says next delivery tomorrow 9 a.m. whatever it is, the stock status you can put it here. Now mi.com or Facebook, sorry, flipkart.com has this particular thing very much applied, that only one person can buy only one product, which also you can set it from here. It simply says enable this to allow only one of these items. So for one login only one stock would be delivered. For example, Flipkart does this, that any one order, any one account, they can only purchase one mobile from that company. So that is how you can set it from here. Same way shipping. In shipping, if you want to have a new rule, shipping costs applied, or you want to charge shipping from the customer, this is the place where you can mention it. So about this shipping class, this is a class that we need to define, and we need to define it from here, from under WooCommerce, and under WooCommerce we go to settings, there the shipping class would be enabled, which I'll show you in a minute. First let's create this product and we'll go there and then create a shipping rule. So link products is a product wherein you find sometimes when you purchase a product or when you are seeing a product, at the bottom of the product there is an option which says something like people also bought or users also purchased. That is how you can add a product here. So whenever any customer is on the page where the mouse product is being displayed. Just below that product, there would be another section which says customers also brought, and any product which you are linking with this, it would start displaying just there. So attributes are something which are which depends upon the what you say, a variance. So I'm saying, if I'm selling let's say grocery, if I'm selling dal, then in dal under attributes I can add 1 kilo, 500 grams, 200 grams, and I'll show you what I exactly speaking. So this is a product attribute where you can set up a different attributes for product. So if I am selling let's say I'm selling t-shirt, now one t-shirt can have X, XL, double XL, triple XL, M, S. So all of these can be added in the attribute section, and whenever a customer clicks on that product, these attributes will be shown. Or if you don't want, you can just delete here. The next is advanced. Purchase note is something which the customer will be able to see when the customer is placing an order. Now this, if I tell you with an example, sometimes when you are shopping on Flipkart and if you are buying any shoes or any size, so you would find a small note when you try to purchase that, and it would say that please get a size bigger or please get a size smaller, which means if you generally purchase 9, purchase 10 for this product, if you generally purchase 10, purchase 9 for this product, something of this sort would be written here. That is how you can add a purchase note there. So the attributes, what I was talking about is that when you go to, let's say, any product, right? So in general, for in this page, if you see, in general the mouse and brownies, in general it costs 45 rupees, but if you select chocolate mousse, the rate would change. The SKU, this is the SKU that I was talking about, so this is a unique code for this particular product. So no matter how you change, you would find the listing or the price. See, from 45 it went to 50. Now you remember, we have a price which is right here. If I go to price, which is right here, regular price and sale price. So this would be the regular price and this is the sale price. So you can set various attributes for this product, and you can select, whenever the customer selects any one of the product, the rates would change accordingly. See, so for brownie I have 55 rupees, but for chocolate mousse I have 45 rupees. So this is how you can set the attributes, and it would let you bill the customer accordingly. Moving over now, get more options, these are as of yet not required. Now product short description. So if you see, this is my product short description. It would be mentioned somewhere in this place only, and long description, which we have written at the top, it would be displayed at the bottom of the product. So I'll just copy this and I will paste it here, and just to understand, I'll write here short, and I'll write here long. Okay, now this is all about the sections on the left portion of it, and coming to the right portion over here, these are the publish menu. If you want to publish, save draft or anything, you can set it from here. This is the category, as I showed earlier. A very good habit is to first include the product in the category and then start adding the product here. Now these are the product tags. Now if you want to add a tag, you can just add a tag here. Repost, mouse, IT, etc. Product image, you can set a product image. Let's say I want to set this as my product image. And gallery, I want to add a gallery. For gallery, I'll take all the images. Right. Now everything is filled, everything is done. I'll just click on publish. As soon as I click on publish, this product particularly will go live. Right. Now since we have taken much longer time, the page expired, so we'll just create the product very quickly and we'll display it. Right, let's write here. Let's write here short description. This is a long one. This will be the short description. Price be 200. To be 100. I am skipping inventory, shipping, all of these. I'll add this to peripherals. I'll set the product image and then I'll add the product gallery. Okay, and I'll publish. So now you will get a confirmation of product published. So when you are publishing a product or creating a product, these all the WordPress or the WooCommerce have a maximum threshold time of 3 to 4 minutes. If you take longer than that, this page will expire. What happened with us? So you can simply go on this link which is available here. And you will be able to see the product which we have just created. Similarly, over here we will be able to find it. We'll refresh it. Right. So this is how the product will look like. So you have sale up top, you have price 200 which is striked out, and have 150 rupees which is the current price. As said at the bottom, short description, which I said whatever you write here, it will appear very at the very side of the product. And then you have category, which category it belongs to. Now you find description. So over here, long description is here where you can post pictures. So if I post a picture here, and so let's suppose insert. So this is inserted and I'll click on update. So imagine you want to show a handicraft product, how it's made. simply add the YouTube link or the video link here, and once the product is updated, it will start displaying at the description area. So when the customer is already looking at the product, he or she will automatically come to know how the product is made. That is how good the description area is. So this is how we basically create an e-commerce website. So this is all it is required here. The next part that we will do is we will see how to add shipping rates, how to add payment gateway, and how to send invoices to customer, and basically do the entire end journey once the product is purchased. So as I said, we will change this first. So now I have one product added, so we will be able to see everything that is available there. So you can continue from here. It will also give you an automatic option of completing the rest of the process. If that is not required, we can continue from here. So once you go to WooCommerce, you click on settings. Once you go to settings, you will now be given options to change the initial settings that we worked upon. So in this page, in the general page, we will quickly cover the settings. So address line 1 is your store address, city. Till here it is all about your, you know, general options, selling locations. If you want to restrict the countries, or if you want to restrict the locations, you can use this option. So sell to specific countries. If you type just India, anyone placing an order from United States, simply it will tell that we cannot ship there. Now shipping locations, you can select accordingly. If you want to ship to all countries, if you want to ship to specific countries only. Now if you want to ship to specific countries, you can also type India. This will limit your products only to India. Now default customer location. If your store and your warehouse or your location is different, you can choose this. So basically these are the settings that you can play with. Now enable taxes is something which you can use if you are using a GST inbuilt in your e-commerce. So that particular charge of 2.8, 18.6, whatever it is, it would be added on top of the price that is that you have marked the product for. Now currency, you can change the currency position, currency separator, everything you can change it from this particular section. For products, okay, let's click on save changes. Right, so in the product section, you can find the changes which are related to products only. So those changes you can do with the specific product or all of the products that you want to. So the shop page is where your products will be displayed. So it is my shop page over here. If you want to create a new page, let's say my shop, you create that, you can select that particular page from here, and the shop contents, that is the products, will start displaying on that particular page. So placeholder image, that is 6 image in a row. So you can go through these options to make your store more beautiful and more featureful. What I wanted to show you here is the shipping, wherein I would add a shipping rate. Say suppose 150 is the product price, and 50 rupees will be flat shipping rate for all the customers. So anyone purchases anything even worth 1000 rupees, the shipping price would remain the same, which is 50 rupees. So that would be same, or that would be added to the MRP for all the orders that go through your shop. you click on add shipping zone. Now shipping zone would be geographical based. So there are multiple options you can play with. You can either add it geographical base, which is if you want to charge separate for separate state, or if you want to have a particular percent of cart value, that means 10% of cart value. Cart value is if my total amount that I have to pay to this site would be 200 rupees for a product, so 10% of 200 rupees would be charged as shipping rate. So see, you have zone name, let's say fast shipping, as we see in Amazon Prime shipping, which costs some amount extra. So zone regions, say suppose I select West Bengal. So now if I just leave West Bengal, that means my fast shipping, this particular shipping rule will only be applied to this state only. And then next I add Maharashtra. So now West Bengal and Maharashtra will only have fast shipping. So similarly, you can add various states where you can ship your products, and the customers will know that, you know, fast shipping is available here. If you want to compare it real time, it is just post the COVID situations, Flipkart and Amazon were opening the shipping rules slowly. So that is exactly how they do. So they, in the shipping area of their CMS or software, they put the locations where they do not, where they want to ship, and only those areas will have shipping enabled. Once you have done with all these, just click on save changes, and then in shipping options, you can go to shipping options to check if you want to add a standard amount or you want to charge a percentage of the cart value. Right, see, now you have enabled the shipping calculator on the cart page. So if you remember, when I was placing an order for the mouse, I had an option below which said free shipping. So that is because I added in the shipping rate that if the order is placed from West Bengal, make the option of free shipping available. I can also add if the order is from Delhi, add 50 rupees. If the order is from Chennai, since it's far from West Bengal, I'll say add 100 rupees. So I can create multiple rules which will be added to the shopping cart when the customer is placing an order. So whatever your store settings are, you will have to make it from this particular page only, because every setting which is there, it is available on the settings under the WooCommerce tab. So here I was talking about adding the shipping classes. So if you add a shipping class name, and you can add a description over here which only you would be able to see. So if you remember, when I was purchasing a mouse, I clicked on deliver it in 3 to 5 working days. So that's a class. Now what happens in the back end when, so customer has placed an order, that is done and dusted, but when the order is reflecting on my dashboard, how will I understand that what shipping charge should I charge the customer? That is where this comes in. So under shipping class, where the customer is selecting free shipping, over here it, for me, it would reflect the name which I give for this shipping class. So let's say West Bengal customer. So my order at the back end, I will be able to look it as West Bengal customer. Then I'll recall that, okay, no, this is now West Bengal customer, I should not charge anything for the shipping. So that is how the shipping class will work. So similarly, you can create a shipping class if you have, see, for a store, if you have multiple shipping options, it is best you create a shipping class for each option. But if you have a standard charge, then you don't need to create any shipping classes, because if you have 50 rupees added per customer per order, then you don't have to have anything which you need to recall. So you know that by default your store is charging 50 rupees for all customers. So use the options as and when you think it is necessary. So now this is the payment method. So over here you will be able to find the payment integrators which you have integrated to your site. So if you have a Paytm integration, you can go to your plugins, then have add new and then install plugin to set up your Paytm. So once you have installed the Paytm plugin, your Paytm option would be available on this page. So this is the page where all the payment options you can trigger with for your website. So I will have cash on delivery available and I will have PayPal available. So as I said, I'll help you set up PayPal. So once you have Paytm here, you would also find the Paytm at the bottom, or PayU or Razorpay, whatever the payment aggregator is, you will find that name below here. And the integration is simple. You need to click on setup. It will ask you your merchant key, your API key. You can log in to your payment aggregator account. You will have all the details available there. Just copy and paste and it will integrate. So you see, it is already giving me the option. Yes, now this is the place where I was talking. So I have a PayPal account. So for PayPal account, I have live, I have an API username, API password and API signature. I need to copy paste from my PayPal account. I need to copy paste these three, and my payment gateway from PayPal would be aggregated or would be included for this payment method. That means it would be interlinked so that I can receive the payments whenever customer is purchasing. So I will not set up the PayPal as of now. So I have two payment methods now. One is my cash on delivery and the other one is my PayPal. You can add more. There are bank transfers available. There are multiple websites where you will find this option, wherein they will display their IFSC code and they'll display their UPI address. You can just type in the UPI and make a payment. Once you make a payment, they will confirm that your order has been successful. So that is how you can set up your payment gateway from this page. So I'll once this is done, I'll also show you how to from where you can install the payment gateway from a payment aggregator. So rest of the things, it is not required because these are all accounts and privacy, emails, integration and advance. So accounts and privacy will have all about your details, nothing about store. Emails is something which you cannot change because this will change per your theme. So if you are using a free theme, obviously, if you are using a free theme, the person who has built his theme will encode the theme in such a way that you cannot change the structure of the email. The email structures will remain similar and it cannot be changed. So if you want to add your own plugin for payment, you can just go to plugins and then click on add new. Once you click on add new, you can click on upload plugin, and the plugin which you have downloaded from Paytm, you can simply click on choose file and you can upload that zip file which you have downloaded. Once that is done, it will unlock and it will install. So that is how you can set up the payment gateway. It is very much simple and self-explanatory. Once you upload it, it will take you to that very page where you can enter all the details. If you click on the help icon, it will also show you from where you can get the details. So I cannot do that because those are very sensitive information which I cannot show on a live session. Now if you refresh this, now I have completed my store setup, I have completed my product upload. Now only thing that is left is to show this entire website in a very presentable way. Okay, so I'll go through the payment process, and then I'll show you how to change the appearance. So we'll keep the appearance for last. So as soon as the customer clicks on add to cart, you will find the amount has been updated here, and as you just put your mouse on the top, you would find your small display about your subtotal, what are the displays, just as you find in today's websites. If you click on the cart icon, it will take you to the checkout page, or you can click the checkout from there as well. So now you have a proper checkout page here. Okay, now I also want to create a promo code, which if I apply, it should deduct the amount or it should give me a discount. So how to add a promo code? So you can go to WooCommerce once again, and from WooCommerce you can go to customers, so this is your WooCommerce dashboard. You can view the complete dashboard of your sales, how much sales you have you done, exact thing which I showed you in the plugins page. And I was talking about the discount coupon. It should be somewhere. I almost forgot, I think. I'm trying to recall the coupon settings. As soon as I get it, I'll come back. Okay, I think we'll have to add a plugin for that. Just give me a moment. So go to plugin, go to add new. So you can type here WooCommerce plugin. Oh, sorry. Okay, I'll have to check from where. I think the option has moved or something might have happened. I'll include that, and I'll send email on how to add the coupons. Don't worry with that. So we can add certain coupons which makes the product just as we have for different and various e-commerce. It used to be here itself, right? No problem with that. So, my screen is visible, right? And am I audible? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Am I audible and is my screen visible? Okay. All right, next we would the last portion that is left over here is we would have to customize this page, and then we would be able to complete the tutorial today about making the e-commerce. Right, once we click on proceed on checkout, here you can add your first name. You can add your phone number, your email address, any information that you want, and you can click on your own choice of payment method. So let's use cash on delivery and simply click on place order. So see, now this order placement is complete. The order has been received on both ends. It is available to be viewed under your dashboard for WordPress, as well as the customer in their My Account section. So if they click on their My Account, they will be able to see the order details just as you are able to see on Flipkart or Amazon or anything. Now see, under My Account, you can go to orders, and in the orders you will be able to find your current orders. So in the dashboard, as I said, if you just click on the WooCommerce, you would find there is one order placed. And as well as in the WooCommerce dashboard, you will be able to find that order details here. There you go. So the order which has been placed is now available to view. So any person which is who is handling the store can look at the order details and find the details about the order and then handle the order accordingly. So thing which is most important here is the backend where you receive the order. So if you just open the order details, you will find from where the order has been placed, which shipping rule has been applied, if it is a free delivery or whatever the delivery details are. So over in this, if you are a team and if multiple people are working, so in order notes you can add payment to be made upon delivery. Over here you can add discount coupon issued, so that next person who is working would know that there is a discount coupon added. So this is an order note section. So in the customs field here at the very bottom, the shipping rule would be visible as to what shipping rule the customer was available. Also, if the customer has returned the order, you can initiate a refund by clicking here. once you click a refund in the selection over here, an email would be automatically triggered to the customer stating that your order has been refunded, and you need to separately intimate the bank to process the order, process the refund. So from here you can change the status. So now from processing, if I put complete and if I update, if I click on update, then this particular order will also reflect as completed in customers my account as well. So if you check in customers my account, you will find the order has been completed. So this is how your basic e-commerce backend work. So from here, this is your entire order details. Now you can add plugins to generate invoice. You can now add plugins to send email to customer about the order status, and you can do multiple things. You can create a delivery slip, you can create the two customers address, the packaging slip that is printed on the top of the package which you receive from Flipkart. So all of those details or all of those functions can be done from this page only. Also, you will find the customer's IP, your date and time, everything in this page. So this is as important as for the customer. Well, the customer can see their order status from this page, and you, being an e-commerce backend support, you can see the order details from here. So this is basically the beginning to end of the e-commerce website designing. Now the last part which is left is to change the appearance of the entire website. So that is also quite simple. If you have come this far, that means that would not be changing this particular appearance will not be that difficult as well. So it's very simple. All you need to do is go to appearance and you click on customize. Once you click on customize, this will give you all the options to change the way the look and feel of your theme which is displayed on the front page. So now once you change here, real time you will find the changes reflecting on this page. And it will only be available to view on this page once you click on publish. So store identity is where the store title and the tagline is. If you want to add a site icon, you can click on this to add a site icon. Site icon is basically a small icon which can be displayed up top here. Then you go to header. Current header, there is no header here. This is the header section. So if you want to add any image, or if you want to add any color, you can do it. So you can change the color. Let's say if I want to have see, it has now changed. Okay, and if you also want to add an image, you can add an image, you can upload an image from here. So let's say I want to add this image. Right. So it will give you the length and size that it can allow. So just select it and click on crop image. So this particular image will transform exactly at the top. Footer, as usual, footer can be changed from here. Background is the background of the entire page. The white here will change. What is main important is the layout. Here, this is general layout. This is a general layout which is shown right. This layout particularly, which is your menu layout. Let's call this a menu layout or the options layout. This options layout is right now at the right side of the page. If you wanted to go on the left side of the page, you can change it from here. So this is one important setting. So you can make the changes if you would like, or you can just leave it. Then the next is the menus. Menus is what I'm able to see up top here, which is not required. I'll just remove the image. It's not letting me see. Right. So now I do not want, so if I want to create a full length full page website, these particularly side menus are, you know, causing an hindrance. So I can remove all that. So you can click on widgets, and under widgets in the sidebar you can remove these if you do not want them. So once those are removed, now below header is this page where below header, if you want to add anything, you can add from here. So let's say I want to add an image. And it would show right below the header. Okay. Now if you are on a home page and if you want to display any page, so see, by default the WordPress theme will always display your post page. So this is a post that we have created. If you want to change this entire screen and you don't want to display the home page as a post page, you can come to home page settings and you can click on a static page, and in the static page you can choose the page as shop. Once you choose the page as shop, it will display your products directly, nothing whatsoever. So once this is done, you can click on publish. And once you click on publish, if you go to tech shop and if you refresh this, the entire look and feel will now change. It will only show what is now required. Now see, I added image just below the header. That is the reason why it is showing this image over here. So if I go back and if I go to widgets, and in widgets I check below header, and if I remove this image and I click on publish, that particular image will now go. So this area and all these are used to display any special offers that you have, or to display any advertisement, Google Ads and all. So you can use that. So now imagine you have tens of products and all being listed just one below the other. This itself would complete your e-commerce website. You do not have to do anything else. Now from where to remove these buttons. So if you just want to keep home button and let's say my account, and rest of the pages you don't want to keep, I mean you cannot delete these pages, but if you do not want to show in this menu, from where you would change, that is also very simple. So right, before moving to menu, let's look at these two options, WooCommerce. So store notice, if you want to put a store notice on top, you can enable the store notice from here. Once you enable this notice, anything that you put here, it would start reflecting entire site wise. So if you just click on publish and if you refresh this page, you would see that a site wide notice would start displayed at the bottom. So this is used nowadays. You would find whenever you go to any website, they will show you that cookies are important or a COVID message, whatever it is done in the similar way. So a site-wide notice is added. No matter on which page you are, this notice will display on the website. Similarly, product catalog, these are all various options. You can play around. Remember one thing, whatever you play around here, click on publish only when you are confident that the changes that you have done here will be acceptable and it will look good. Alright, so now we will go on how to change this up top image. Oh, sorry, up top menu. So for that, we will go back to the dashboard area, admin area, and from there, if you see on appearance, you would find an option which says menus. Click on menus. So I am showing this menu here, and this menu, under this menu, I do not want any other menu option other than home and my account. So if you see on this menu page, I can manage the menus with live preview, which means it will edit and show me the menus in real time, and if only I am satisfied, then only I'll create save. Okay, I'll create a new menu. Okay, and in the menu I will write it as primary, and under primary I'll click as primary menu, click next. Now I'll have add menu items. Now in my menu items, now you will see that I can remove any of these pages, so I don't need sample page. I need my home page and I need my account page. Now if I want to add a reference to any external website, so let's say I want to add the company website, I can simply go under categories, or I can simply go on custom link and I can type, let's say I want to go to google.com. So I'll just add google.com and I'll like Google. So this is to show you that you can add anything on the link page. So now you see that there is a home, there's a my account, and there is this Google. So as soon as I click on Google, it will navigate me to google.com, and if I click any other website, it will navigate me to that website. So if I just want these two, I will just leave it to this, and I have my all the menu from up top gone, and there is just two menu which is remaining, which is home and my account. So this looks somewhat acceptable other than what it was previously. So next, let's add some slideshow of images, just in case I want to, you know, show some products or whatever, which would make my site look further good. So similarly, I go to plugins, I go on add new. Now remember, I set my shop page as my home page. Okay, so anything that I want to add in this page, I'll have to add it from shop. Okay, so in add public plugins, I put a slideshow. I type slideshow and it will give me an option to add a slider. So I'll add a meta slider. So whenever you are installing any plugin, just ensure that you see it is compatible with the version of WordPress that you are using. So it would be ticked over here, and if it is not compatible, it will just write untested with the version of WordPress. So only go with the ones which are compatible. Do not go with the ones which are not compatible. So once that is done, I'll click on activate. And you would find the meta slider here. Just click on meta slider. Okay, so it will now ask you to drop your images or choose your images. So I have some of my slideshows created. I'll use them. Let's say I use these three. So it is very important to jot down the points that you would first want to do. So whenever you are creating a website such as e-commerce, the first step that you have to do is you will need to create products. So only once the products are created, you would be able to know where to exactly paste them and from where you can easily view them. Right. Now see, my product is now added. Okay, so over the side where the menu is available, there are two ways from where you can add this slider. I'll show you the easiest way to add. All you need to do is find a meta code. So in WordPress, there are meta codes where you can just use the meta code and paste it anywhere to copy. Anywhere you want to display. So either it's meta code or it's a short code. So how you would get the short code? If you look in the settings or in the place for that app, you can find that there will be a short code which is displayed here. So yeah, in short code, just click this short code and you can go to your pages. Now if you go to pages, remember I told you that it's the shop page that I had chosen it to be the home page. Just open your shop page. And paste the short code that we had copied. So we would also remove this word shop so that whenever I am landing on my home page, this should look the yellow portion, then the slider and then the products directly. That would look more better when anyone is viewing my page. So let the page load. So I don't need the shop. I just need the slider or the short code. If you click on preview, this should give you a preview of the page that we have created. Let's see if the changes has been properly applied or not. There you go. So exactly in this way we can add a slider, we can change the length of the slider. So we can go back to the meta slider and we can change the size of the slider. Just go to your meta slider, click on meta slider. You can change it from here. Let's say I increased the width to, let's say, 1000. And I save it. Once again, I refresh it. Let's open it here. Okay, so this is not proportionate enough, so we will increase it further. Let's say we put it as 1500 and we increase this to 500. So this is how you will need to play around for the exact size. So you can either know, okay, I can simply check this, the product. I can just check the product dimension. So it's 1293 × 770. So I'll just put it there. 1293 × 770. Let's see first what we have done is correct or not. So the idea is you can play with the size of the image and you can create a slider which can then display upon the main page of the website. So exactly this is how you can create the e-commerce website, and rest all, everything can be managed from the plugins. So if you want to add anything to your site, you can go to your plugin and search if that particular plugin is available or not. You can also search for Facebook share. If you find that plugin, you can embed it so that whenever the customer wants to share the product on Facebook, they can do it. So in this way, you can create your WordPress plus WooCommerce website, which can help you start your own e-commerce. So I think this would be all for the session. If you have any questions, please put forward. You can also send me an email. I think the session went too long. Some might not understand complete as well. So I'll upload the entire session once again on YouTube. You can check it. And further, if you have any doubts, you can definitely email me. So my email address, I'm sharing it on the comment section. You can note it down. And I hope you found this session useful. So if there are any questions, please let me know. Or if it's not, we can end the session. Alright then, thank you guys for joining in, and I hope that you have found this session useful. Be in touch, and if in case you need any help, please do let me know. Thank you and have a great day.